We are finishing the ultimate mixture challenge today. So we're going to see which group can successfully apply what they know about mixtures to design a method that's going to separate the mixture with those three solid materials. Go ahead and tell your group, what three solid materials are we trying to separate today? If you know the answer, I'm looking for those learning bodies. That shows me you're ready to go. What mixtures are we separating today, Adalia?
The mixtures we're trying to separate are gravel, diatomaceous earth, and sodium chloride.
And I love that she used complete sentences and she used those proper scientific names we're working on. I want you guys to look over here for just a second because I've updated our science board over here with a couple special words. Who notices the two new pictures I put up that were not up before? Krishna, what's one of them?
Solution.
Okay. Go ahead, tell your partner, what's a solution? We've learned this one already. Okay. Antonio, what's the solution? Good, and what about the coloring of that special kind of mixture? Mariah, what do we know about that? Solutions are clear. Why would I put that underneath mixture? What's the connection between a mixture and a solution, James?
That a solution is a type of mixture.
Yeah, so not all mixtures are solutions. This is a special kind, but every solution we have is a mixture, right? It has more than one substance with different kinds of properties in it. So, we have another word up there, though, and it is particle. Everyone say particle.
Particle.
Mildred, how do we say that in Spanish?
Particula.
Everyone, one, two, three. Particula. And that just means a small piece or part of something. I've started using that word a little bit, but we haven't really talked what it is. It just means it's a part. So these right here, these are particles of rock. And this is particles of sodium chloride. So sodium chloride, the salt that we're using, is actually much bigger pieces, but when we put it on our food, it's been ground up. So they're small pieces of salt. Because if we tried to put a piece of salt like this big on our food, wouldn't taste very good. Go ahead and raise your hand if you're in a three-person group. Okay, so remember, when we pair share, what's gonna happen to that third person without a partner? Who can tell me, who are they sharing with Krishna? Yeah, you share as a whole group. So pair share, or if you need to, group share. What is a particle? And make sure you use that word particle. Go. I love how Adalia turned her body when she saw me walking over here. So what is a particle, Laura?
A particle is a small piece or part of something.
Okay, and I put particle underneath property. The reason I did that is because we're talking all about particle size today. So how big are those pieces of our substance? So we have particles of gravel. We have particles of diatomaceous earth. And we have particles of sodium chloride. And I really want you to think about how does the size of these particles affect how we separate it out of a mixture? So how does the size of the gravel affect what kind a filter we use? How does the size of the diatomaceous earth, those particles, affect it? At the end of today, I'm going to be asking you about particle size, about how you, what you noticed about the particle size of the different types of matter we're studying. So go ahead, tell your partner what I'm going to be asking you about at the end of the lab today. So what am I going to be asking you about at the end of the lab? What was I just talking about? Yeah. So Jonathan, what am I going to be asking you about?
The size.
The size. And what kind of size? What's the special word I just taught you?
Particle.
Yeah, the particle size. Everyone, what am I going to be asking you about?
Particle size.
Okay. So we are just about ready to get started. You have already studied your background knowledge. You have already designed your plan. So now it's time to do your lab. So I'd like everyone to make sure you are on the page that has all of your steps and give me a thumbs up like Adalia is doing when you're on the correct page. In just a few moments, you're going to be reviewing your steps and then getting your materials and getting started. But you need to know how to fill in the middle, because that's the part you're going to be filling in next. Point on your worksheet to the section you'll be filling in next. Okay, so then I want you to look up here. How I want you filling that in, these are your quick jots of how it goes. So you might just write worked. If that step did what you wanted it to do, you can just write worked and then go on. You can also write down anything that went wrong. Like maybe when I did this step, the DE, what do you think DE stands for? Marquise.
Yeah, these are my jots, so I can use abbreviations if I want. As long as I, the scientist, know what they mean, that's okay. So DE stuck to gravel, added water and tried again. So you're going to write any changes you make, because part of being a scientist is sometimes making a mistake. Maybe you have a step that doesn't work. You're allowed to fix that during the lab. Or you can write down things like it mostly worked. Okay?
So those are just your jots. Are you going to write complete sentences down for that?
No.
No, you don't need to. You're just jotting down how it went. Each of you has one of these. Go ahead, have one partner hold it up. Okay, this is a resource you're going to use to help you today. Go ahead, put it down. Who can tell me what's on the front cover? Mia, what's on the front cover?
Frames.
Yeah, our frames. Who can remember, who can raise your hand? What do we use these for? Why do we have these, Victor?
Because if you agree with one of your partners, you could say, I agree with you, I also think.
Yeah, it's a way to help you use that academic vocabulary. Because remember, we talked about as scientists, we want to use that sort of dressed up language to really help express our ideas. So during the lab, just like we use these when we were planning, you're going to use these during the lab. Because if you do something and you think it works right, you want to make sure your group knows that too. So if we do a step and Axel and I are talking, I might say, hey, this step worked perfectly. And Axel might say, I agree with you. I also think it worked perfectly because it filtered the gravel. Or he might say, I think our perspectives differ because I still see diatomaceous earth on the gravel, so I don't think it worked. It's important to have those kinds of discussions because you're working together as a team. We're doing teamwork today in science, so it's important we have those good discussions. Okay, turn the page.
Is it okay I'm borrowing your Axel?
Thank you. Okay, the next page, this we talked about already, these are your resources. Okay, so as a group, before you're allowed to get your supplies, you have to look at this, and I want you to write down on here how many of each you want to use. And then, you're going to come to the back of the room, and we have a whole countertop full of all the supplies you might want to use. We have Post-its down here. We have our funnels, and they're tipped over because sometimes these pieces come out, so you'll carry it over like this, and then turn it over on your desk to use it. We have evaporating dishes. We have craft sticks, screen filters, syringes, cups. We have filters, and remember, these filters are folded already, so you want to take the folded ones, not the unfolded ones. And you have to open them so that you have a pocket. If you open them just in the middle, it's not going to work. It's not going to hold whatever you're trying to filter. And then we have water in this, okay? So just be careful so you can actually take your syringe and fill it up when you're ready to do that back here. Be careful not to spill it. So when your group's ready, you'll mark on here what you want, sort of like your shopping list, and then you'll take your dry mixture out of your tub, take your paper towel out, and then one person will bring this to the back and get what they need, okay? But you're only allowed to do that after, as a group, you go through all of your steps. You need to read out loud every step. This is your last chance to check, to fix anything before you get to start trying. Thumbs up if that all makes sense. Okay, because this is going to be a pretty independent period as you're doing your experiment. So when you're done, remember, as you're going, you're filling this in, and when you finish, the first groups that finish, I want you talking about overall how do you think you did and what changes would you make if you were going to do the whole thing all over again. Go ahead, tell your group what I want you to do when you're done.
Okay.
what I want you guys to do. What I want you talking about at the end. Yeah, if it worked or if it didn't work, and would you change anything? Okay. So, I think we're ready to get started. Thumbs up if you are ready to try the Ultimate Mixtures Challenge. Raise your hand if you think your group will be successful at the Ultimate Mixtures Challenge. Keep your hand if you think your group will be the most successful. You have the best plan of everyone. Okay, so there's some competition in here. So, next week, you're actually going to write up your plan, and then you guys will get a chance to see everyone else's plan in the class and sort of evaluate what strengths the different groups have. But for right now, we are ready to almost get started. Really quickly, please review the lab rules with your group. Go. Wow. See one group done? See two groups done? And now every group is done. Excellent. Okay. If there are any questions before we get started. Okay, so Mrs. Link and I will be walking around to help you out and guide you, but we're not going to tell you if we think your step's going to work or not. This is on you as scientists to evaluate. And we're going to use this word revise to go back and change using this column any things that you think you might want to do differently. Yes, Victor.
As soon as we get our materials, we can start.
Yep, you are free. But remember, before you get materials, what do you have to do, Baruch?
Read the instructions.
You have to read your instructions because as scientists, you never just go out and start doing things. You look at what you're supposed to do first. You look at your plan. So when you're done with the plan, you make your shopping list and then send someone to the back with your bin to get your supplies. Okay, good luck. I can't wait to see how you do. Go.
You are going to read through all your steps out loud with your group.
Step one, use syringe to pour